Good morning, dears. Last class, we learned what is decimal numbers, how to represent the decimal number, how to write the decimal numbers, and the expanded form, everything we learned. Now, today's class, we are going to compare the decimal numbers. How to compare? Look at, we have three steps to compare. Only three steps I wrote here, but we should continue more steps also if the decimal number is extant. The comparison of decimal numbers, the first step is compare whole number part of the two numbers. The decimal part that has the greater whole number part is greater. Once again, I'm telling, compare whole number part of the two numbers. We know the decimal part has two parts. One is a whole number part, other is a decimal part. Which number first you have to compare? The whole number part. Or else we can say an integral part. We can say this one integral part. Compare whole number part of the two numbers. Then the decimal part that has the greater whole number part is greater. Suppose if you are comparing two decimal numbers, if the whole number part is greater, that number one is a greater number. If it is the whole number part is equal, then compare the digits at the 10th place. That after the whole number part, decimal part, what is the first place? Is a 10th place. So we should compare the 10th place. The decimal number that has the larger 10th digit is greater. The decimal number that has the larger 10th is greater. Suppose if the whole number part also equal, if it is the 10th part also equal, what we have to do? Then what is the next step? After the 10th place is 100th place. After the 10th place is 100th place. So we should compare the 100th place. If the whole number part and the digits at the 10th place are equal, compare the digits at the 100th place. The decimal number that has the larger 100th digits, what we have to do? Then next you should proceed that 100th after 1000th place, or hundreds after 1000th place. The same procedure can be extended to any number of decimal digits. First, we should compare the whole number part. After that, go for the decimal part. Decimal part also, we should go step by step. First is the 10th digit, then 100th digits. Suppose, if necessary, we can go other steps. And one thing you should remember always, zeros added to the right end of the decimal digits do not change the value of that decimal number. Do not change the value of the decimal number. Suppose 4.5 and 4.55. That's what I wrote that place also. Suppose if I'm adding here 4.50, that zero will not change the value of the decimal number. It will not change the value of the decimal number. That's what we are saying. Zeros added to the right end of the decimal digits do not change the value of that decimal number. So we'll take one example. Compare the numbers 45.55. How to read 45.55 and 45.5. So for our procedure, first you should compare the whole number part. Whole number part. For this decimal number, what is the whole number part? Whole number part is 45. Here also, whole number part is 45. So we should go for the 10th place. What is the 10th place? 10th place also, both the number has 5. So we should go the 10th place. Here 10th place is 5. What about this 10th place? Now I am going to add 0 that place. Now only I told, if you are adding the decimal digits to end of the decimal digits, if you are adding 0, do not change the value. That's why I am adding 0. Then only we can compare the 10th place. So 5 and 0, which is a bigger number? Now 5 is a bigger number. So 45.55 greater than 45.50. Once again, I am explaining, dear. Here, both the number, whole numbers also same, equal. That's why we are proceeding to the 10th place. 10th place also, both the numbers also have 5. So, that's why we are going to that 100th place. 100th place, here 5, that place is 0. So, which is a bigger number? 45.55. Then 45.50 is a smaller number. This is the way we have to compare the two decimal numbers. Now, we are going to that exercise 1.3. What the first problem is given to us? We have to find out the smaller number. So, if you are comparing the two numbers, then only we can find out which is a smaller number, which is a greater number. Here 2.08, here 2.086. So, for our procedure, we should compare the first whole number part. First, we have to compare the whole number part. Here, both the numbers also same, no? So, what we have to do? Proceed to that 10th place. Look at the 10th place. 10th place also, here also 0, here also 0. Now, go to the 100th place. What about 100th place? 100th place also, here also 8, here also 8. So, now whole number part also equal, 10th place also equal, 100th place also equal. So, go to that 1000th place. Here, we don't have any 1000th place. So, now I am adding 0. Then here 2.086, which is a bigger number now. 2.0866 is a bigger number. So, which is a smaller number? 2.080. This is a smaller number. So, smaller number is 2.08 is a smaller number. The same way, if you are proceeding the second problem, look at the whole number part. Whole number part, which is a smaller number. 0 is a smaller number. So, easily we can say smaller number here 0.99. Don't want to go to the 10th place, because after looking the first whole number part itself, we can say 0.99 is a smaller number. Now, come to the third subdivision. Here, look at that whole number part. If you are comparing the whole number part, both three also same. Now come to the 10th place. Here 5, here 3, which is a smaller number. 5 or 3? 3 is a smaller number. So smaller number is 3.35. Come to that fourth subdivision. Here also both the whole number part is equal. So go to the 10th place. After looking the 10th place, we can say smaller number is 5.05. No need to go to the 100th place. After looking that 10th place itself, we can say 5.05 is smaller. Come to the 5th subdivision. Here whole number part is 123. Here whole number part is 12, which is a smaller number there. That smaller number is 12. So, no need to compare the decimal place. We can say 12.35 is a smaller number. 12.35 is a smaller number. Now, come to the second Roman. Arrange the following in ascending order. What is the question they are asking to us? Ascending order. How to arrange the numbers in ascending order? Smaller to bigger or bigger to smaller? If it is arranging the numbers in ascending order, we should arrange smaller number to bigger number. This is the way we have to arrange the numbers in ascending order. What are the numbers are given to us? 2.35 2.53, then 5.32 3.52 3.25. now Our procedure, we should see that whole number part. Here 2, here also 2, here also 5, here is 3, here is 3. So, if you are seeing that whole number part, it is a smaller number, 2 is a smaller number. So, we will take these two numbers, 2.35, then 2.53. First, we will arrange these two numbers, then go to the next digit. Now, 2.35, 2.53, which is a smaller number now. Look at that. 10th place, 2.35 here, that place is 2.53. 5 or 3, which is a smaller number. 3 is a smaller number. So, first number is 3, 5, then 2.53. Now, here 5.32, here 3.52, here 3.25. Now, we will take these two numbers, 3.52, then 3.25. Now, the both whole number parts are equal. So, go to that 10th place. Here 5, here 2, which is smaller number. 2 is a smaller number. So, the next number is 3.25, then 3.52. So, we have only totally 5 numbers. Already we wrote here 4 numbers. 1 alone is remaining, 5.32. 5.32. So, 2.35, 2.53, 3.25, then 3.52, less than 5.32. This is the way we have to write the numbers in ascending order. Come to the second subdivision, 123.45, then 123.54, 125.43, 125.34, 125.3, 123.45, 123.54, 125, here also 125, here also 125. Now, we see that whole number part, here 123, here also 123, but the three numbers also, whole number part is 125. Comparing these two numbers, which is a smaller number, 123 is a smaller number. So, first we will take these two numbers, 123.45, then 123.54. Now, we have to see that 10th place, here 4, here 5, which is a smaller number, 4 is a smaller number. So, 123.45, then 123.54. Now, we have to see the three numbers also, because this interval part is 125, but three numbers also. Now look at that, 10th place here 4, here 3, here 3. Here 4, 4 is a bigger number comparing to 3. Now 125.34, 125.3, which is a smaller number, 125.3. Both also 3 only, no? What about that 100th place is here 4. Now, I am adding 0. If you are adding 0, it will not change the value of the decimal number. So, I am adding 0 for comparing these two numbers. If you are comparing 40, which is a smaller number, 30 is a smaller number. So, we can write the third number, 125.3, 125.34. Then, only one number is remaining, that 125.43. 125.43. So 123.45 less than 123.54 less than 125.3 less than 125.34 less than 125.43. Come to the Roman, compare the following decimal numbers and find the greater number. How to find the greater number? What is the first subdivision is given to us? 24.5, 20.32. After seeing that whole number part, we can say easily 24.5 is greater. Now come to the second subdivision, 6.95, comma 6.59. Here both the whole number part also equal, so compare that 10th place. Here 9, here 5. This is a greater number. 9 is a greater number. So 6.95 is greater. Come to the third subdivision. 17.3, 17.8. Here both the whole number part also equal. Then look at the 10th place. 8 is a bigger number. So 17.8 is greater. Come to the fourth subdivision, 235.48. This both the whole number part also equal. Look at the 10th place. Here also 4. Here also 4. So now proceed to that 100th place. 8 is a greater number. So 235.48 is greater. Come to the fifth subdivision, 0.007, 0.07. Here we don't have any whole number part, so look at that decimal number part. Decimal number for 10th place is 0. Here also 10th place is 0. Go to that 100th place. Here 0, here 7. So which is a bigger number here? 7 is a bigger number. So 0.07 is greater. Come to the sixth subdivision, 4.571, 4.578. Now if you are comparing the whole number part, both also equal, then go to the 10th place. That also, here also 5, here also 5. Then go to the 10th place. This also, both also equal, 7 7. Then go to the 1000th place. 1000th place, here 8, here 1. So 8 is greater than 1. So 4.578 is greater number. Come to the fourth Roman. We have to arrange the numbers in descending order. If it is ascending order, how to arrange the numbers in ascending order? Smaller to bigger. That opposite way, if you are arranging the numbers in descending order, smaller number to bigger or bigger number to smaller. How to arrange the number is bigger number to smaller number. The first subdivision, 7.35, 71.53, 51.73, 73.51, 37.51. So the same way we are proceeding these problems also. Look at that whole number part. Here 17, 71, 51, 73, then 37. Which is a bigger number here? If you are comparing these five numbers, 73 is a bigger number. So we can take 73. No need to compare that decimal part now. First we have to compare the whole number part. If you are comparing the whole number part, if you are identifying 73, 73.51 is a greater number. Then go to the next term. 71 is a greater number. So 71.53. So both also we wrote. Now go to that next number, 51, 37, 17. Which is a bigger number? Here 51 is a bigger number. So 51.73 is also we wrote. Go to the fourth number, 37.51, 17.35. Here no need to compare the decimal part. If you are comparing the whole number part itself, we can identify which is a bigger numbers. Now come to that second subdivision, 456.73, 546.37, 563.47, then 745.63, 457.71. Now compare that whole number part. If you are seeing the whole number part, which is a bigger number, 745 is a bigger number. So 745.63. Come to that second number, you can easily identify 563. Here also no need to compare the decimal part. If you are comparing that whole number part itself, we can say which is a greater number. Next number is 457.71. Then next number is 456.73. After seeing that whole number part, we can identify 745 is a greater number than 563, 546, then 457, then 456. Now come to that fifth Roman. Fifth Roman is objective. They are asking to us 0.09 is equal to 0.90 or 0.090 or else 0.00900 than 0.900. They are asking to us 0.09 is equal to which number? First look at 0.9. This definitely it will not equal to this number because the 10th place here 0, here 9. Now come to that second subdivision, here 0.0. The 10th place is 0, but come to that 100th place here 0, here 9. So this also not. Come to the third subdivision, 10th place 0, 100th place 0, then 1000th place also 0. After that we have two zeros. What about these two zeros? Already I told you, if the decimal digits, the last number, if you are adding zero, it will not change the value of that decimal number. So here that third subdivision is that right answer. 0.00900 is equal to 0.09. Come to the sixth subdivision, they are asking to us 37.70, then which symbols should come here, equal or less than or greater than or not equal to 37.70. Already now only I told, if you are adding 0 in the last digit, it will not change the value. So if you are removing 0, what is the value of this one? 37.7. This also 37.7. 37.70, we can write it as 37.7. So equal symbol only should come. Then seventh one, 78.56. 78.57. Which symbol should come here? Equal or less than or greater? Both the whole number part also equal. Come to the 10th place. 10th place also equal. Come to that 100th place. Here 6, here 7. So which is a bigger number? 78.57 is a bigger number. So less than symbol only should come here. So now we are comparing the decimal numbers. We compare the decimal numbers also. And we know how to write the decimal numbers also. Now we are going to represent the decimal numbers on number line. You know how to write the how to draw the number line and how to represent the whole numbers on the number line, how to represent the integers on the number line. Already we learned how to write the fractions on the number line. We are going to represent the decimal number only on the number line. Why I am using the word fraction? Because what are the fractions? Has the denominator part is multiples of 10. That numbers are called as a decimal numbers. So if you know that how to write the fractions on the number line, easily we can represent the decimal numbers also on the number line. So this is the number line. I'm starting here 0. Then should maintain the even distance all the numbers. So 3, 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5. Now, this is a way how to draw the number line. We have to represent the numbers on the number line. That already you know. That's why I'm not giving any details about that number lines. Now, we are going to represent 0.8 on that number line. This number, how to write 8 by 10? How to write this 0.8? We can write it as 8 by 10. If you are representing this number 0.8, this number will come to 0 and 1. So first you will divide this 10 divisions. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then 10. You should divide that number in between 0 and 1, 10 divisions. There are 8 tens. How many tens are there in 8? 8 tens. Now, this number is more than 1 or more than 0, more than 1 and less than 1. So divide the unit length, divide this unit length into 10 equal parts. Divide the unit length into 10 equal parts. That's why I am dividing here 10 equal parts. Now 8 parts only we need. We need 8 parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a 8 part. So 0.8. How to represent 0.8? First we should identify the decimal number in between what two whole numbers. After that, identifying the whole numbers, divide the whole numbers into 10 equal parts. 10 equal parts. After that, we can represent the number easily. After that, we can represent the number easily. Now, we'll do that exercise number 1.4. That 8 tens, 0.8, we can write 8 tens. We can read also 8 tens. So that's why I'm dividing the whole numbers 0 and 1 into 10 equal parts. Then 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the whole numbers in between two numbers, I'm dividing 10 equal parts. Here also, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 is another whole number. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. We should identify what are the decimal numbers represented by the points P, Q, R, S on the given number line. Given number line. This is Q here, P, then here S. Yes. And what about R? R is here. Now come to that Q. Q in between 1 and 2, lies between 1 and 2. So after that, after 1, how many parts we have? 1, 2, third part. Third part is representing Q. So Q equal to 1.3. After 3, third part is representing Q. So 1.3. Then come to that number P. P lies between 3 and 4. Which part is representing P after 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sixth part is representing P. So 3.6. Come to that S. S also in between 4 and 5, S is in between 4 and 5, then which part is representing S after 4? After 4, second part is representing S, so 4.2. Come to that R. R lies between 6 and 7. After 6, which part is representing R? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8th part is representing R after 6. So 6 is a whole number. Then 8th part is representing R. So R equal to 6.8. Once again I am telling dear that Q is lies between 1 and 2. Then 3rd part is representing Q. So Q equal to 1.3. Come to that next number is P is given to us. P lies between 3 and 4. Here 6th part is representing P. So 3.6. Come to that S. S is another number, another letter is given to us. S is lies between 4 and 5. After 4, second part is representing S. So 4.2. Then R number is, R letter is lies between 6 and 7. So 6 is a whole number. After that, which part is representing R? 8th part. So 6.8. Come to that second Roman. Second Roman, represent the decimal numbers on the number line. 1.7 is given to us. So how to draw the number line? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what is the whole number part? Whole number part is 1. So definitely this number lies between 1 and 2. So 1 and 2. Now I am dividing this unit length 10 parts. I am dividing this unit length 10 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after 1, which part is given to us? 7. Decimal part is 7. So count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is a decimal number, 1.7. Zero and one, then two. Listen carefully. This 1.7 is definitely lies between 1 and 2, because here whole number 1, the next whole number is 2. The number lies between definitely 1 and 2. That's why this unit length I am dividing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now after that 1, what is that decimal part? 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1.7. Come to that second number, 0.3. Second number, 0.3. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what is that whole number part? 0. So that definitely this number lies between 0 and 1. This 0 and 1 unit length only, we should divide 10 equal parts. 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then 10. Now, which part we need? What is the decimal part? 3. So this is a number 0.3. This is a number 0.3. Come to that next number. 2.101234. Look at that whole number part. 2 is the whole number part. The number definitely lies between 2 and 3. Which unit length you should divide now 10 parts? 2 and 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So after that, what the decimal part? 1. So this is the number 2.1. This is the number 2.1. Come to the third Roman. Between which two whole numbers the following decimal numbers lie? First number is 3.33 is given to us. Second number is 2.5 is given to us. The third number is 0.9 is given to us. Now only we have identified what are the numbers lies between these numbers. Now 3.3, look at that whole number part 3. Definitely the number lies between 3 and 4. Now second one, the whole number part is 2, so the number lies between 2 and 3. After the 2 we have 5 parts now, so definitely 2 and 3. Here also after 3 we have 3 parts, so definitely 3 and 4 only the number lies. Now 0.9, what is the whole number part? 0. 0 after 1, so between these two numbers 0 and 1 only the number lies. So 0.9 lies between 0 and 1. Come to that fourth Roman. Find the greater decimal number. Already we did in the last exercise. Same way we should identify the greater number. Same way we can identify the greater number. 2.3, 3.2. Which number is greater number? Compare that whole number part. So 3.2 is a greater number. 3.2 is greater. Come to that second subdivision. 5.6, 6.5. Which is a greater number? After seeing that whole number part, we can say 6.5 is greater number, because 5, 6, which is a greater number? 6 is a greater number. So after seeing that whole number part itself, we can say 6.5 is greater. Come to the third subdivision, 1.2, 2.1. Compare that whole number part. Here 1, here 2, which is a greater number? 2.1. So 2.1 is greater. Come to that fifth Roman. We should identify the smaller number. First subdivision, 25.3, 25.03. Here it is a smaller number. Compare that whole number part. Here also 25, that place also 25. Come to the 10th digit. Here 0, here 3, here 0. Which is a greater number? 3 is a greater number, 0 is a smaller number. So 25.03 is smaller. Come to the second subdivision, 7.01, 7.3. Which is a smaller number, dear? Here both also, whole number part also equal. Come to the 10th place, here 0, here 3, which is a smaller number. 0 is a smaller number, so 7.01 is a smaller. You can ask one doubt to me. Here 2 digits we have, here only 1 digit. How you are saying 7.01 is a smaller number? Definitely this doubt you can raise. Come to that 10th place. Whenever we are comparing the two numbers, first you should compare the whole number part, then 10th place, decimal part 10th place, then 100th place. If you are going the 10th place of 0, 3, here 0 is the smaller number. After that only we should move the 100th place. If 0 is a smaller, immediately we can say that is a smaller number. Come to the third subdivision, 5.6, 6.05. Compare that whole number part. 5, 6, 6 is a bigger number. 5 is a smaller number. After seeing that whole number part itself, we can say 5.6 is smaller. Two more objectives only we have. Come to that sixth Roman. Easily we can say the answers these two questions also. Sixth one, between which two whole numbers 1.7 lie. First option is given to us, 2 and 3. What is the whole number part here? Whole number part is 1. After that we have 7 parts. So we can say that 1.7 lies between 1 and 2 or 2 and 3, definitely 1 and 2. So that third subdivision is answer 1 and 2. Come to that sixth Roman. This is the sixth one, this is the seventh one. The decimal number which lies between 4 and 5. The decimal number lies between 4 and 5. Come to that first option, 4.5. Second option, 2.9. The third option is given to us, 1.9. Fourth option is given to us, 3.5. Now, what is the question they are asking to us? The decimal number which lies between 4 and 5. Look at these four numbers. Only look at the whole number part alone. This is 4, here 2, here 1, here 3. Definitely it won't come to 2, it won't come to 1, it won't come to 3. Because 4 and 5, definitely 4, the whole number only lies between these two numbers. So 4.5 is that answer. 4.5 is the answer. So today we learned how to compare the decimal numbers, how to represent the decimal numbers on the number line, and addition to that we learned ascending order also, descending order also, and we are finding the greater number also, we are finding the smaller number also. That's all this lesson, dear. Thank you, dear.